Good morning, mayong aga, magandang umaga. Welcome to the Writing Effective Feature Articles o pagsulat ng lathalain topic. So today, this very moment, unfreeze your minds. Now, you just heard those two topics. Medyo seryo siya. Ang writing news, the news writing, and also the other one, the editorial writing. So, pag sinabi natin feature writing, it is more lighter. It is lighter this time o ang pagsulat ng lathalain. So, children, high school and elementary learners, congratulations na kayo ang napili ni Mom at ni Sir na sumali sa ganitong contest. Ibig sabihin, kayo ay talagang readers, magaling magbasa, rich in vocabulary, and you really do love writing. Kasi ito naman talaga ang kailangan kapag ikaw ay isang feature writer. Bakit? So, what is a feature? A feature article is a good story told well in print. So, sabi nga, pag magaling kang magkwento, magaling kang feature writer. As one editor said, a news story is like a textbook. Gusto niyong magbasa ng textbook. And a feature story is like a novel. So, ganun yon. To be well-rounded, you read both. You turn to the textbook for information and knowledge. You pick up the novel for entertainment, escape, and enjoyment. It instructs, informs, and advises, but its main objective is to entertain. So, wag mawala sa reason why you are writing because you are a journalist. Still, you have to inform. Now, feature writing, as I said, hindi tayo mawawala sa facts. Andun pa rin yung katotohanan dapat sa sinusulat natin. Hence, it is not the same as novels and short stories. Aba, ma'am, kanina sabi mo, yung feature writing, ano yun? Parang novel siya. Pero bakit hindi ako makaka-imagine na lang? As I said, we are journalists. Although, we are trying to entertain people, still facts should be there. So, because of that, we have to know the qualities of a good feature article. It deals with any topic. Yes, you heard it right. Any topic under the sun, or even the sun itself, they say. It usually entertains more often, and it informs, instructs, or advises. It may be long or short, as long as it covers the subject adequately and keeps interesting to the readers. If you observe, marami tayong nababasa na maikli lang, meron namang mahahaba. Pero, see to it, ano man yung kahaba, the interest of your readers will still be there. It may be light or serious, depending on its purpose. It could be formal or informal, and written in any form and in style, but well organized. Diba, mga especially elementary, yung gusto nyong ipaabot, minsan nawawala ka, then you really have to go back. Ano ba talaga ang gusto mong ipaabot? It should be organized. It may or may not be timely. If story should be, news ay dapat timely siya, dito naman sa feature writing, kahit yung nangyari pa sa panahon ng lolo mo, ay pwede mo siyang maisulat, ma-featureize mo siya. It begins with a novelty lead. So, dapat you will really have to attract, you have to attract your readers. It is written in ascending interest. Hindi na very excited yung nagsimula, then bigla na lang, wala ng energy. It is based on facts. Though sometimes the writer uses his imagination to play up the details, it is still anchored on facts. So, facts pa rin, andun siya. It can be garnished with adjectives. Sino ang kumakain ng salad, di ba? Ito, pwede kang kumain ng salad na walang garnishing, walang design. Pero pag may garnishing, may colorful veggies, ma-add up yung interest mo na kumain nun. So, ganun siya sa feature. Figures of speech should be rich, the dialogue, the anecdote, local color, and idiomatic expressions. So yung mga nakakatawa na mga kwentong narinig mo, maikli lang siya pero nakakatawa, pwede mo siyang ilagay sa feature. It can be written in the first, second, or third person. So, ganun yun. So, review natin ha sa mga elementaries. First, of course, yung sarili mo, I, me, may, magagamit mo talaga yun sa feature writing. Yung second, parang may kausap ka. And yung third, may pinag-uusapan ka. Ganon. So, next. So, ma'am, ano ba pwedeng i-topic? So, sabihin ko sa inyo, maraming pwedeng maging topics when it comes to feature. So, we can have the profiles, the character sketches, yung mga kilala, experiences, inspiring narratives, the travelogue, saan ka pumunta, saan magandang puntahan, yon. Social concerns or phenomena, the how-tos, paano gawin to, paano lutuin yan, yon. Trends in different fields, food, fashion, and technology. Also, we can have competition. So, sports ba ma'am pwede? Of course, competition. At kung ano-ano pang mga contest sa schools, di ba? And next, we can also have the conflict. Conflict is talagang andyan yan, no? Sa magkakapatid. Sino ang mas mahal ni mama, ni papa? Conflict yun. Whether between or among individuals, groups, associations, kahit saan, may kompleto. To controversy, ano daw, mga magpapakasal na si ano, so that's controversy. Whenever people disagree or argue, if that debate has at least a potential impact on others, those others suddenly become interested. And that's a good topic for feature. For the consequence, if readers consider the story important, they'll give it their time. Ito importante to. Babasahin ko to. So ano bang importante sa panahon ngayon? I will write about it. Family and community, home and school, food and shelter, jobs and leisure, healthy and looks, ethnicity and electricity, weather and water are of consequence. Lahat ng mga bagay na to, you can write about these things. Also, familiar or famous persons. Sino ba ang mga famous persons sa school, sa community? You can write about them. Also, fear. Eh, ma'am, di ba sabi, dapat mag-i-entertain. We have to entertain, but we have, bakit fear? Yes, when we write feature, we can really also write about fear. It's negative, granted, and many folks aren't drawn to negatives, but those shadows and forces, visible and invisible, that threaten or harm us, definitely attract our attention. Eh, may mga pupas nga kami, pag napunta kami ng mga bookstores, walang bibilhin kundi yung nakakatakot, tapos yun, nginginig-nginig, kasi natatakot. Pero ba't nagbasa? Because it is interesting. And so, we can also use that in feature writing. Wow, heart-stirring. The race against death from a killer disease, a homeless child, finding love and family, a jobless and aging couple receiving comfort or help. These may not be important stories, but they're magnets for most readers, no? So yung mga paubaya na mga sitwasyon, yun ay mga heart-stirring. So pwede talaga siya isulat bilang feature. Okay, humor. No, humor, nakakatawa siya. So, if the situation calls for it, and writer, editors knows how to know how to handle it, why not? Usually, yung mga writers, medyo serious daw sila. Pero, there are those who are really talented and very humorous. Dito natin magagamit yung mga anecdotes. Just like the other day, yung contestant naming isa sa school, kilala ko rin siya kasi pamangkin ko. Sabi ko sa kanya, ano gusto mo sa photo journal? Sa Filipino ka ba or sa English? Sabi niya, math. I want math, no? So, sumasali pala siya sa journal. Hindi niya alam na wala dun math writing ito. So, it's something, it made me smile. At kung susulat ako, I could use that na beginning ng aking isusulat. It could be an anecdote of someone joining a contest na hindi niya talaga alam kung anong pinapasukan niya. Humor makes people laugh or chuckle, and that's good. If you could make people laugh of what you are writing, then you are one very effective feature writer. Problem. Discover something that your readership deems a problem and you've got yourself a built-in audience for the article and you converse about it. Although it's a problem, it will really entertain. Next, progress. Yes, we want progress. We're thrilled by it, or at least encouraged. It gives hope to us. Progress against disease and raging elements, against unemployment and illiteracy, against discomfort and hatred makes us feel better. We like to read about what makes us feel better. Diba nang sinabi, hindi na tayo pupunta ng school? Ano kaya ang mangyayari? Hindi na ba kami papasa? We will just be staying in our own grade level. Then we realize people in the DepEd are doing their best na mag-progress pa rin tayo. We will move on and it's something we can write about. Next, the solution or success. If there are problems, there are solutions. The victory, the triumph over odds, the race won, the mess cleaned, the confusion cleared. Editors should seek to chronicle such encouraging events. And that's a good topic too. The unknown. Yes, mga bata. Teenagers, you are so interested with this. Ano kaya meron sa end ng rainbow? Nasa panahon ninyo ngayon, alam nyo na na nothing is there at the end of the rainbow, pero sa panahon namin noon, natatakot talaga kami. What's in the end ng rainbow na yan? At the end of the rainbow, ano kaya meron? It's so unknown for us. The mysteries of a vast universe and mini micro subatomic things intrigue us. Ano meron sa kabilang planeta? Ano meron sa kaldero ni Lola na ayaw niyang buksan? From ocean deep to heaven, we're inquisitive about what we do not know, and it's a good thing, about angels, about heaven, about hell. Next, the unusual. What? Ano? Ba't nangyari yon? The old man bites dog, diba? Sa news writing, yun, we call it news kung kakaiba siya. Also, in feature writing, the old man bites dog principles that journalists have traditionally followed still works. A cheating business magnate is sentenced to endow a chair in ethics. Ano? Cheater siya? Pero ano siya? Naging manager siya? Sa isang university? Naging president siya? That is so unusual. I will write about it. A girl writes the president of Russia about peace and love and it is invited to see him. It is unusual. Of course, these things interest us. The eccentricities, the departures from the norm make pleasurable or adventurous reading. Yung kakaiba talaga, hindi pa siya nangyari. Yung kagabi, yung binalita na ilang kilometro yun, nagbike lang ang tao para ihatid yung package, kakaiba yun. Kaya finiture nila. The wants and needs. Anything your readers believe they want or actually do want or need, they'll read about it. You can count on it. No, yung mga pangangailangan. Ano bang pangangailangan ng tao? Kasi pag kailangan mo, it interests you. So why not write about it? Okay? Next. Now, okay ma'am, maganda pala magsulat ng feature. So ano ba yung techniques? Kasi ma'am, baguhan lang ako. So children, kids, ito yon. The 5 techniques. Adding specific information, choosing words carefully, creating sensory images, using figurative language, and writing dialogue. Iisa-isahin natin. Paano ba ito gamitin? Specific information, identifying specific activities and behaviors. Describe the actions that the characters are doing as concrete and as specific as possible. Eto ha, we have here 2 kinds of sentences. Ang isa, we use this kung normal lang, wala kang intention na mag-entertain. Ganito lang, isusulat mo lang siya ng ganito. And it is poor when you are a feature writer. The man left the bag in the street. Yun lang, di ba? Boring. Pero, when you featureize it, you do it this way. The man turned to the left towards Elm Street. There, he dropped the package that conceals the mysterious object that the cops were chasing after. Now, it's interesting. Next, specific information, naming and describing characters. Describe the characters by telling us about their physical appearance and personality. So you have to picture out really the characters. How will you do it? Ito ha, the good thing na magagawa natin when we are using the feature, only a happy-go-lucky teenager like Justine can afford to cram his work like that. Tall, handsome, and athletic. He loves it more to be in the field than in the classroom. So nakita mo si Justine kung gaano talaga siya ka-lazy. Pero pag sinulat mo lang siya, simply, Justine is very lazy in school. Pero sa feature, pinahaba mo siya so that readers will be able to picture it out. Specific information, identifying and describing settings. Describe the setting down to its specific location, the time, and even weather. Example, eto ha, ano siya? Kung boring lang or simple lang, gumagawa ka lang talaga ng sentence, New York City was a scary place to go to after the terror attack. Okay, yun lang. Pero pag good siya, covered with a huge cloud of debris, ash and smoke. Ito, may mga aso-aso na. New York City became a ghost town after the Twin Towers fell last September 11. Now you can feel na ano siya, sad na siya. Nakakatakot. Ano na talaga yung atmosphere in that place? Next, specific information listing attributes. The characteristics include other details and observations that will make your description more interesting. This is how you do it. Pag ito lang, simple lang siya, it's poor. The boy walked along the beach. Diba? So, sinong boy? Maybe I will imagine about the boy na naka-shorts, yung iba matangkad, may iba mataba ang ini-imagine. Masaya siguro siya, pero when you featureize, you do it this way. Wanting only to be with the hymns of the seagulls and the melody of the crashing waves. O, diba? Nakita mo na the waves were crashing. The boy went out of the noisy hotel and took a walk along the beach as the sun colors the sky with deep red. Pwede mo nang mapinta. So that's how we do the feature writing on it. Next, creating sensory images. Now, we talk about senses this time. Good descriptive essays appeal to the reader's five basic senses. Okay, kids, ano five senses natin? Okay, so we have here the sensory images. These are words that create a mental picture of the topic. Subject, one is describing in such a way that the words or phrases used appeal to our five basic senses. Yung ating mata, yung ating, mamaya, iisa-isahin natin. Yes, the sense of sight first. The glittering sparkles of gold. The bluish haze of the sky. So, for example, nagsusulat ka. Sasabihin mo lang, masaya sa bahay, di ba? Pero pag gusto mo talaga makita nila, marinig nila, you can say, tawanan, kulitan, biruan, ang laging naririnig sa aming tahanan. So, sasabihin ng nagbabasa, ay, ang saya nga nila, no? So, next, the sense of smell. Pwede bang ma-smell ang binabasa? Yes. The invigorating aroma of coffee. The putrid and damp scent of the canal. Pa, nako, parang naaamoy mo siya. So, halimbawa, sa Filipino, binigyan ako ng mabangong bulaklak. Yun, simple lang yun, di ba? Hindi siya featureized. Pag finiture mo siya, nagising ang natutulog kong damdamin dahil sa napakahalimuyak ng mga rosas na napakasariwa. So, yun, parang ano talaga, you can picture them out after that. Also, the hearing. The clattering of coins, the thud of a basketball, parang naririnig mo siya. Humahangos, tumitibok-tibok na puso. Okay, naririnig mo na ngayon. Then, the sense of taste. The sweetness of chocolates, the savory flavor of beef curry. So, pag sinabi mo naman, nakakatakam, nakakalaway na luto ni nanay. Parang, ay nako, tanghali na, kakain na ako dahil sa nabasa ko. And also, the sense of touch. Yes, kahit that sense, dapat talaga may feel sa pagsulat. The humid atmosphere in the tropics, the rough edges of a rock. Halimbawa, nagsulat ka tungkol sa pusa mo, nanginginig sa lamig si Kuting na makita ko siyang pinagsiksikan ng kanyang manipis na katawan sa makapal at magaspang na pader na napipicture out talaga siya. Okay? So that's for the senses. Now, gusto talaga ng Roja City Division na magaling kayo. Kaya, these are the tips for good feature writing pa. Make the lead inviting, clear, and simple. So, simple lang, pero clear. Use quotes when they speak louder than a paraphrase. No? Use examples, anecdotes, as I said earlier, parang review na lang ito, and details when they help make the point of the piece. Give the story movement by blending paragraphs with transitions, by using short words, and by varying sentence rhythm. Pwede yon. Good writing is built on a foundation of solid reporting. Go to the scene. Talk to the source personally. For example, nag-feature ka talaga ng isang tao. Go interview para maano mo, makuha talaga yung gusto mong ipaabot ng iyong feature. Also, we need now. We have to do the word craft. Paano siya? Parang ano pa rin siya? Related sa kanina natin pinag-usapan. Be specific and bring people in. Make your readers involved. Halimbawa, ito ha, not specific, more examples for you. She appreciated the beauty of the Sampaguita in her mother's garden. Pero pag specific na, ganito na siya. Luis's heart warmed upon seeing the Sampaguita's long stems coiling around the trellis while flowers perfuming the late afternoon air in the mother's garden. In her mother's garden. So, you try. Make the sentence specific and bring in a person. Try it now. He owned a brand new car that impressed everyone. Okay, you can have the screenshot then. Try it later. Next. Animate, the inanimate, yung walang buhay, bigyang buhay, no? Leaves are on the floor, ganun lang, yung daw, nandun lang sa floor. Pero, pag animate na siya, leaves lie on the cold floor, as if tao siya. Na yun, nakalay siya sa floor. Inanimate, the hills had no vegetation of the mine's sulfurous fumes. Pag animate na, the hills are strapped of their vegetation and the mine's sulfurous fumes choke new growth. Animate, yun siya, animating the inanimate. Now, let's go to show, don't tell. Ito lang, pag nagtitell ka lang, and it is not effective in feature writing. Johnny was happy when he received his package. Pero sa show, John ate excitedly opened the package from his sponsor. His eyes lit up. And a broad smile appeared on his face. I love the toys. Yung sinabi ni John, sinabi talaga. They're beautiful, he said with a giggle. Eto, when you just tell, Jose Roman worked hard. Pag show mo sa feature na, before the sun could rise, Jose Roman would wake up and prepare the fishing nets. He pushed his banca to the shore and paddled by his lonesome until he was in an area where fishes abound. From there, his work day begins. Ganun siya ka nag-work hard. Now, you are showing. Another activity for you to practice. A man who proposes his love to a woman. Ito ang next example niyan. Paano? Papakita. It was like Pepe's Sunday was a rain of kisses when his heart is pounding with all I love yous towards Trisha. All the butterflies played rock and roll in his stomach as his sweat went rolling down like excited warriors for a battle. But Pepe was in a different battle and it was to win Trisha's coveted yes that would mean a heaven to Pepe. Like a mighty wave of the vast ocean, his heart, fully tanked with love, has just exploded, through his lips saying, "Trisha, kinahigugma ko ikaw." Diba? High school! And both of the world were enchanted with the magic of love. Kag ang nagbasa, magkilig-kilig na. Okay. Next, structure of the feature story. Descriptive and narrative techniques this time. Okay? A feature story must have a main theme. This is a story writing version of the hard news angle. The main theme is always the spine of the story. Everything else branches from it. Why is the theme useful? It is where you organize your facts, quotes, and anecdotes. As I said, wag mawala. The theme is what your feature is about. Ito ang isa. Feature article style A na gustong-gusto ko rin gamitin. You have the lead, usually anecdote or quote. Example, my favorite quote ka, time is so blah blah. You will have a quote there. Then you go now to your introduction of person or situation being featured. Then the thesis. Then the significance of the topic, further description. And of course the conclusion now. Yung lead mo, kinonclude mo na ngayon, andun na lahat. And then, maganda siya pag yung conclusion mo, minsan ginagamit nila yung ginamit nilang quote sa una, ginamit nila sa conclusion para masettle siya. Then, this style B, point of crisis. There's a problem. May crisis. Then, the flashback. Bakit nangyari ang problem na to? If a flashback mo siya, moment of insight, what have you learned from that situation? Resolution. Ano ngayon ang solusyon mo? Pwedeng mabigay na solusyon. Then, lesson learned. Pwede na masabi mo sa audience mo or sa reader mo ang isusulat mo in that last part. This one, among the journalists, ito laging ginagamit nila, is the Wall Street Journal formula on writing a feature story. Hindi naman nagkakalayo. Of course, you still have the beginning. And the beginning, start with an anecdote again, just like ang kanina, the illustration. And then the theme, shortly after the beginning, state the point of the piece. We have there the body, provide details that elaborate the theme. Tell the reader what is happening and why and what's being done about the situation. And of course, the ending. Mag-end talaga ha, baka mabitin yung readers niya. Okay. Are you ready now for the practice? Of course, push that pen. Thank you for listening. And later, we will give the exercises or the contest piece. Exercise na contest lang na output ninyo for the feature writing. Thank you so much and thank you for watching. God bless.